गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. एज ऑन सैटरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस टॉपिक लेटर राइटिंग एंड इनफॉर्मल लेटर्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन फॉर्मल लेटर्स. एज वी हैव डिस्कस इन दिस कैटेगरी देर आर बिजनेस लेटर्स, ऑफिशियल लेटर्स, लेटर्स टू एडिटर्स, लेटर्स टू द स्कूल अथॉरिटीज, बिकॉज दीज आर ऑल फॉर्मल एरियाज. ओके, so these are under the category of formal letter. Actually in informal letter we always write to our parents and to our relatives and to our friends. So not more formalities. But when we are going to write formal letters, we have to follow a certain pattern, as well as we must have to follow so much formalities also. Okay, so let's start with the format of a formal letter. Actually the format is the same, but few things we have added here more. The first and foremost thing here, as we did in informal letter also, in formal letter also everything must be written in left hand side only. Okay, nothing is going to be written in the right hand side. So first we will start it also from the sender's address. It will be 90% into your question. If 10% in case there is no address, then you can write your own address. But keep this thing into your mind, after writing address, no need to put full stop or comma. Okay, then leave one line that write down their date. Okay, then leave one line, then receiver's address also it is going to add here. To whom we are going to send our letter, we have to write that address also. Suppose there is a receiver, the editor. So our receiver address will be the editor, the Rajasthan Patrika, and below that there will be Jaipur. Like this we have to write. Subject also it is going to add here. On which topic we are going to write this letter, we have to write down the subject also. Salutation. Okay, salutation means when we are going to write it to the editor, we will use dear sir. And with rest of the subjects, we will use only sir. Okay? Sir and dear sir. After writing that, no need to put comma. Just leave that line and start your content just below, just from the very next line. Okay? Then body of the letter, conversation, communication. We have to write down. These are the formal letters. So here it is needed to write more lines in comparison to informal letters. Okay, language will be completely formal here. No need to write how are you, I am fine and all that. Just leave them, because these contents we are only going to use in informal letters. Okay, informal letters no need to do such kind of formalities. I am just sending you few examples. You can automatically understood that in which manner we should write it. Okay, then subscription. Just remember two things, yours truly and yours faithfully. You have to write down here this thing. Yours apostrophe S will not be there. This form we will write like that. Okay, two things. Either you can write yours truly or yours faithfully. And at the last, name and signature, whatever given in your question paper. In case there is no name, anything is not there, you can write your own things. Own name. Now look at the complete pattern. Just you have to note it down into completely into your notebooks. Examples I am going to send you, and examples you have to note it down into your notebooks. And beta, one more thing, if any point is not clear to you, just send me a message or you can call me. I will repeat it again. But just keep, actually in composition part the main focus must be on the presentation. In which manner you are going to present your letter writing, that is more important for you all. Okay, so write it into a good handwriting. Every content must be in the left hand side only. And after writing address, date, salutation, subject, salutation and subscription, no need to write any full stop and any, no need to write any full stop or any comma. Your presentation must be good, because that is the main part of a letter writing. Okay, and when you are going to write sender address, date, receiver address, just leave one line between them. So it must be very impressive. Thank you and have a nice day.